Today, we are going to present jointly Mr. Puneet and myself. We worked for controller's building at Mumbai. When there was a time, we were using only 2GB, 4GB computers. And now the pen drive is consisting of 8GB, 16GB. Now presently we are using computers of 1TB, 2TB storage facility. We were using floppies and CDs at a time. Now we are using all cloud-based, internet, all those things. And all these cloud-based and internet-based works, it is going to get storage. Storage will be done in a data center. That is actually a data center. I thank controller's team for making me understand what the data center is. The data center consists of a big racks. Let's say this is a rack. Assume that it's a rectangular box. It's a rack, 0.6 meters by 1.2 meters. Each rack will be there, and 2.4 meters height it will be there. And from the mother slab, it is going to be resting on a this kind of arrangement. At 0.6 meters by 0.6 meters, each leg will be there. On that, these racks are going to be placed. Below this, the data cables will be flowing. And all the data cables, they are going to connect it to the racks. And in between the racks, there is going to be aisles. So whenever there is a maintenance requirement, they'll just pull it out, and people can go inside and do the maintenance. Perhaps that maintenance part may not be required once it is installed. And of course, there is going to be cables connected, hung from the rooftop also for the all the services. And that each rack is going to be around 1200 kgs to 2500 kg. Can you imagine that kind of a load in any scenario? No. Sometime back, what we did in one of the engineering college, they wanted one more floor extra. Then what we found that the foundation was inadequate as per actuals. But professor insisted me to do some exercise. What we did, we have weighed all the furniture of the, that means benches in a classroom, and instead of 60 students, we have taken 90 students, and the overall weight of each person, we have calculated 70 kg. Then we got only 97 kg per square meter. Do you think the kind of a load, what we designed for 400 kg per meter square in a hotel, generally, we hardly get 100 kg. All the people, including the furniture here, let's see, it is going to be 100, 100 plus or minus 10. So, but as per the code, we have to, as per the codal guidelines, we have to go for 400 kg per meter square. I don't want to deny that, because Professor Madhavan is also here, IIT professor. So this is a large live load complex that is going to be 1800 kg per meter square. It is going to come as a UDL if you look at it. But each rack is going to weigh 2.5 tons. That's a very huge load. And this data center is something, it is called Tier 4 requirement. Tier 4 requirement means they source from two ends, the feeder also, power they'll get it from the two ends. From the feeder, they'll get the direct power, and also they are going to have a DGs. DG sets are also, it is going to be an additional capacity they are going to install. Apart from that, they are going to have a DG for 7-day storage. That means in any eventuality, the data center should not, stop, even for a blink of a second. So that's the reason the data center and the requirement are huge. And their design requirement is also very high, like, you know, zone 3 is the Bombay, but we have been asked to design for zone 4 of an earthquake requirement. Controllers is Asia's largest tier 4 data center player in 5,000 racks at single location in Bombay. Tier 4 means highest standard in redundant data center with 99.999% uptime standards, 4 hours downtime in a year. That means not even there should not be any chance for the stoppage of the activity in a data center. The present building, what we have done, we got a LEED certification, platinum LEED certification in data center verticals. The structure is designed to take live load of 1800 kg per square meter. The floor to floor height is approximately 5 meters almost, and in some cases it is 6 meters also. As the existing building is basement is adjacent to the proposed building, what we had to do, we have kept 6.5 meters from the existing building. So we had to give 6.5 meters cantilever. So even for the cantilever also, it was very difficult to design in a normal flat slab or any design. But we have achieved in steel structures. To get more clear height, for such a huge live load, we opted for composite flat slab design and also to achieve timelines. They are very particular about the timelines. Kirby has done marvelous job. They have completed total from August 5th, they started erection, and October 31st, they have finished the erection part for 12-storied building. Can you imagine? That's an amazing feat for the Kirby also. I appreciate that.
No, it was because of the design and other things. The details which were available, actually it helped in construction. We'll take you through that.
Yeah. This is at the foundation level. The footing size was 5.7 meters by 5.7 meters and the maximum pedestal size was 2.1 meters by 2.1. And this is the stage where they have erected all the columns and they started erection of the flat slab design. So this is a flat slab. I will just demonstrate how it is we have worked out. These are the model what we have prepared. It is one side it is 12.9 meters and other side it is 12.9, other side it is column spacing is 9.6 meters. And so what we have done, this is a steel structure, this is a Kirby scope what they have done. So we have taken a more depth here and they wanted a more clear space in between for the services. Regular flat slab, but it is a steel structure with a composite action. What we have done in between also, there are going to be members like this. Once all the erection of one floor is done, so we are going to keep deck sheet from the bottom, not from the top. And people, most of the steel structure, what we do is, from the top, after finishing, we'll be keeping all the deck sheet on the top. But here, the case is different. What we are going to do, this is the way we are going to erect. These initially they found it very difficult. Better, I think, Mr. Puneet is going to explain that. And steel, reinforcement steel, we are going to keep on this. And the rest of the place also, we are going to keep all the deck sheets below this. This is the deck sheet profile, what we are going to do. And once it is done, we are going to put up concrete. Concrete also, like, there is a possibility that this deck sheet can fall down. Here, what we have done, we have calculated and we have made one mock-up also at the Kirby. And we have done only 50% we have filled. And rest of the 50% we have filled in the next day. So that we could able to achieve the, I mean, the problem of falling down also we could able to achieve. And the timelines also we could able to achieve. And from the bottom, in fact, Hilti people, they have given us the hope by doing the bullet, nails.
Nails.
Bullet nails, from bottom they have done the work and they helped a lot in that also. Once it is done, one level, they keep on erecting on the top. So, this way, they'll complete the erection part up to 12 floors while doing the concrete at the bottom floors. That's an innovative idea actually, what together we have done. And I'll just show you the slides how it happened. This is a during erection stage. This is a beam size is, I mean, steel beam, main beam, steel beam is 400 is the web and 10 mm thick.
Keep it inside.
And the flanges are 250 by 12. And smaller size beams are 200 by 8, that's a web, and 200 by 10 flange. Three sides, their requirement was 2 meters cantilever. And bottom reinforcement also they have done. This is a crucial moment for them. That's a deck sheet fixing from the bottom. After finishing, it looks like this. And this is a capital area. If you can see, that's a projecting down. And the rest of the area, it is going up. That means it's a flat slab, but it's a composite section. Yes, sir. Yeah, that is actually, Mr. Puneet is going to explain it in detail. I'm just, what it is, he is the expert in that. I'm going to take his advice. And, no, that is also we are coming back. In fact, there's a cantilever of 6.5 meters just adjacent to the building. So we had to control the deflection while pouring the concrete and while the erection is happening. What we have done, we have taken tendons with the turnbuckles and we have lifted up maybe, I think, 70 mm upward camber we have done. After finishing the concreting part, then we have released that slowly. And 50% we have concreted in one go, and the next day we have completed the rest of the slab. This is how it looked after finishing. The beauty is, because of the deck sheet providing from the bottom, we could able to increase the fire requirement also. That deck sheet itself will take 2 hours fire rating, and including a slab thickness of 270 mm, we have taken the up to 4 hours fire rating. Their requirement was 4 hours fire rating. And during brickwork stage, they have finished the complete erection. They have finished the slabs at five or six levels. And also they have started the brickwork. You can see the picture. And this is almost in the finishing stage. And the timelines, if you see, 23rd June 2018, they are fixing the bolts. And this is the 31st October 2018, they have finished the erection part. And while we have done some of the floors, concreting also. Yeah, I request Mr. Puneet to continue. No, it's okay.
Huh?
Yeah.
So, or you can continue with
this. I'll just finish with some of the important steel structures done by SHPL. The Trivium, so Phoenix Trivium project at Hafizpet we are doing. That is 50% of the building already completed and occupied by Genpact, and rest of the portion now it is going on. This also for the Phoenix, it is in a financial district. So this is done by, again, Kirby. And the previous one is, Penner is doing that. This is a Halshen, Etna. This is also, again, for the Phoenix. This is a, how many floors? This is four basements, ground plus eight floors. It is in a finishing stage now. Halshen Olympus is also in a finishing stage now. So I request Puneet to continue on this.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Other presentation. In continuation of the project which we were discussing, he has talked quite a lot about Kirby. I will give a slight idea about what we are doing, what capabilities we have, and then we will take this data center project in further details. See, the company Kirby, for most of the people it's well known. I'll just take you through. We are generally associating ourselves with industrial projects, but very few people know that Kirby nowadays are doing a lot of other than industrial, multi-story projects also. We are not going all out and publicizing in every newspaper or any other media, but slowly we are developing our portfolio and will be in a position to market it in much better fashion in years to come. But as the people are very relevant here, we are trying to say what Kirby is doing here. Other than the industrial buildings, we have developed almost 6-7 structures into steel, which is either in completion stage or completed and are in at a very advanced stage. Our presence, if you know, is across Middle East, in India, and also in Southeast Asia. We have two plants in India. One is in Haridwar and another is in Hyderabad. And both the units are capable of delivering similar type of structures. These are the plant location worldwide we have. We have units in Hyderabad. One is in Haridwar. Another is in Kuwait. Another one is in Ras Al Khaimah. And the last one is in Vietnam. These plants in India are focusing on industrial as well as multi-story structures. We have got various achievement as recent presents, you can say the awards which we have received in recent times. These are few of our clientels. We are working with all the latest designing and detailing softwares, you name it, our guys are equipped. But we are also, these are actually not only for industrial, even for high-rise structures. This is our basics fabrication line, which is very advanced in all terms of automation and speed of production. We have added few things like CNC saw line, CNC drilling line, and also some other balancing equipment to make this plant world-class as well as suitable for very precise applications and applications which requires multi-story products. This is a French straightening machine and also a high-speed plate drilling machine which we have installed. We have online three short blasting lines. One is where the sections also can be directly inserted and can be grid blasted and short blasted. There are a few complex projects which we are doing. One of the build, you can see the complexity in this project is the box sections with reinforced already built in the structure itself and shipped as it is to the site. I think now we will come specific to the project which Mr. Sridhar Reddy was talking about. It is one of the most unique project which I think nobody in India in steel industry has done till now. It was actually a very unique scenario where client had a requirement which was never spelled out, was never being there, and he wanted to continue the thing which was available to him. See, the client briefed us saying, if you see the building photograph, this is the architectural view after the building is completed. Okay. Now, if you see the smaller building was the existing building, which was already there. It was a data center building, which was running, and also you cannot stop any work in that particular building. And the new tall tower was to be constructed adjacent to it. The client's brief was that it has to be very similar to the RCC structure which was coming up, which was already there. Now, in this particular thing, as he explained it, it was a complete flat slab construction. Now, the idea was that you had to maintain the similar features of the flat slab and continue in a steel construction. The building was to be, the main requirement was that it should have been completed in 5 months' time. That was the main challenge. Otherwise, they could have gone and constructed a RC building also with flat slab configuration. Then actually, he suggested a lot of things to them. And finally, there was, further, based on the client's brief, the requirements were understood, a lot of options were worked out. In a crisp form, it was like this. The slab thickness should be aligned with the existing thickness. That was the main criteria, because he had to see the continuity in the building up to fifth floor. That was the major agenda. Then the structural system, either whether it is an RCC flat or whether it is any other thing, but it should completely mimic the RCC system. That was the another requirement. Otherwise, we could not, we cannot have the continuity of the structure. The slab beams should not obstruct any of the existing ducts and the panel layout. As he was explaining, what is the panel, there was a false floor, a lot of other things were there in it. It has to exactly do that. The capital area, he was allowing us up to 569 mm. And 369 mm was the other thicknesses. You can add on.
Yeah, 270 mm.
Okay. And there was another parameter, which is for data center, there were some international standards, ANSI, and for a tier 4 system. That was the main thing, that was the driving force while he was designing the structure. And I've just put a slide out of it, where you can see the light highlighted area, where he was saying that for tier 4 structures, in the last column, the steel deck and infield is the solution for it. That is what exactly was actually done. Now, final scheme, which was finally agreed between the customer and us and the designers, was it has to be a prefabricated steel solution. It cannot be anything else. The steel framing was to be designed considering it is a flat slab configuration. And all primary and secondary beams were to be encased in concrete. This was an additional, as he was saying, an additional advantage of giving a fireproofing to the beams also. There's no additional requirement of taking care of the fire protection. The columns were finalized as a box column. This was not regular I sections. It was again considered as a box column. And that too with filled in concrete. It was also a composite column with concrete being filled from top. Again, the reinforcement was also the cage was ready and supplied to us, and it was to be inserted before erection and the concrete to be poured after it. So this was having all sorts of complexity and all sorts of composite configurations possible in a system. And these were actually basically they were trying to remove the dependency of site civil work, because that is the time consuming thing and that is what is going to take the excess time. So considering that timelines were only 5 months, this was the final scheme agreed and finalized. The challenges were many. There are a few challenges we have tried to list out. Most important task was to implement this scheme on ground within 5 months. That was the most important thing. And the configuration of such structural system was never done anywhere, which we were knowing, like we could have taken a reference or like somebody could have guided us, like this is what you have to do. There was nothing like that. So it was the first time, as far as our knowledge goes, to achieve this critical timelines, prefabrication and standardization of the steel member was must. This was the main requirement. Like you could not achieve anything like this until you do prefabrication and also do some standardization so as to achieve, you know, consistency. And we have to see three aspects. One is detailing, another is fabrication, and third is the erection. So everywhere the standardization and prefabrication was to be utilized at full. The complexity, as he was explaining, was in the beams, and many, like on a floor plate, there were approximately 520 beams and a floor plate of almost 1,000 square meter. So that was the complexity. Like you will never have so many beams in such a small, dense condition. This was causing a major hurdle during fabrication, and also it's not a one floor building, it was a multi-story building, and at every, you know, heights of you can say up to 72 meters, you have to achieve this. The detailing or the Kirby, actually what we suggested and discussed with them, proposed a, you know, pre-assembled beam system. A grid was formulated with consultation with consultants. We have to sit together and see how fabricability of that thing, and also transportability of that thing, and third is the erectability of that. All these things were discussed on drawing board before we have released it for fabrication. This required a lot of planning, and that too in a very short time. Again, still with all this thing, we were not able to do, you know, complete online fabrication. There were so many members which are still required to be, offline fabrication was still done. Our request would be to the consultants and designers to see that from the fabrication perspective also, as much as prefabrication is possible or offline work is reduced, it will help us. You can see this slide in which what we have tried to show is a Tekla model, and the different colors are the grids assembled together from the factory and shipped to the site. You can see these were like, this is the density of beams. You can appreciate that. And every color will signify that this particular area is assembled together, connected together, pre-assembled in factory, and still able to be transported and lifted at the location. The next complexity, which was for the box columns. It's a photograph of the box, which is, you can see the smaller picture where you can see the height of this. This is almost like the person's height. It is so big a box. And this has to be again done on a online thing. If it has to be done manually, it will take years together. But we developed or we modified our fabrication line to, you know, some extent, and the delivery of 12 boxes per two floors was achieved and supplied at site. The other complexity, as we were just discussing, is the connections, where our designers, they and our detailers sat together, worked out a scheme which has to take care from the erection and fabrication perspective. The beam and column connections were main drivers for the faster erection, and the design of fabrication of connections were done with extension of the sections welded with primary beams and provided with end plate arrangements to receive the further segments to the beam. This has helped to increase the erection speed. In fact, that was a unique designing detail where the beam connection was not going and fitting inside another beam. The connection was brought out of the beam line. And that is normally a practice to go as close to the member, but here it was brought out and designed. And also, of course, that has spent some extra steel in it, but of course, this was to take care of the timelines of erection. At flat slab region, the connection was planned in such a way to facilitate the pod lifting. Again, as we were showing those photographs where every section was a you know, a colored section was to be lifted. So we made some arrangement to pod lift also. Like every center of gravity of every assembly was considered while arranging the lifting arrangement. The large, he has explained in a very nice way, like there was a huge 6 meter cantilever to connect to the existing building. There wasn't, like you could have gone as close as possible to the existing building, but there were restrictions from civil perspective. They have to design a very big cantilever. The another point was how to erect it. So then there was some arrangement done at site to put some additional strays to lift it at location.
There were water tanks were available, existing water tanks. We should not disturb that. Otherwise, what happens? No, then we cannot. I mean, that 6.5 meters was obligatory. That is the reason we had to go with the 6.5 meters.
Yeah. The this is just a stat. Sorry, not stat. This is the Tekla detail where you are showing a typical connection. If anybody wants in more and like understanding on this, this is just a picturization of that how the beams are connecting to the. For the like the beam network, how it is connected. Now, let's come to the erection. Erection was a very special and very, you know, very complex for this particular building. You can see the building was erected using two lifting arrangement. One was a tower crane in the first picture you can see, and the other is a mobile crane, which was a hydraulic arrangement. The tower crane had a tip load of 7 ton at 80 meter radius. Okay, and it can go any height, actually up to 72 meter was our requirement. So it was taking care of that. But the mobile crane, we had a limitation. The erection was not possible after some height, after let's say 5 floors and above, this crane was of no use. So this was the arrangement and the site, you know, in Mumbai. Mumbai is the most and one side was packed from the existing structure. So there was no storage place, no erection space available to lift this material or do the erection. You can see, this was the actual photograph where you can see the density of all the beams, which is like so many beams coming and this guy is confused, like how this has to be, you know, further done. Another important thing, as he has, you know, something which was very unique was a bottom fixing of deck sheet. Somebody asked also why bottom. So we also were in the same dilemma, why bottom? But he had some very, you know, reasons to have it. One was definitely to mimic exactly the flat slab construction. It has to be as it is. As per the flat slab, the customer was also saying, I need timelines as this, but it should look like a flat slab. That was the main problem.
The main reason was the rack height is 2.4 meters and the raised floor is 1 meter height and we have to match the existing RCC flat slab. Otherwise, what we could have done also, like a regular steel beams and a deck slab and painting with the intumescu paint also would have been the solution if the floor height, floor to floor height would have been 6.5 meters like that. But here the case is we have to match the existing structure and we have to match the existing lines should pass through. All those things are very, very, I mean, it's a very challenging one. That's the reason we had to go with a flat slab. But the timeline we have to achieve. That is the more important.
So finally we accepted that challenge and it was now no discussion on here where to fit the deck sheet or anything. It was to be done from bottom. We tried 2-3 ways, whether a normal, you know, self-drilling screws will work here or anything new has to be thought of, because again, holding that in position, challenge was to hold the sheets in position from bottom. How? It's not a small work, and also at heights, as we move up, it will become further difficult. And for screwing the nails, it was still to achieve the speed of erection, which was, they were not compromising anything on the speed of erection. For holding the sheets, what we did was we arranged some, you know, screw jacks. We kept the sheets and kept it from the bottom and tightened it. That was the way we did it. And then, as he said, like a new system was developed for, you know, shooting the nails from bottom for fixing. Otherwise, it was impossible. The machine for screwdriver and other thing was impossible to handle. It was a new proposal which was from like our design detailing and design team with them, has set in detail with the supplier. He developed a good mock-up in our factory. Even all the condition was simulated there, and we tried to put that nailing system from bottom. And we found that, okay, you are still not achieving the speed what we can do it from top, but it was still, you know, within the timelines we can achieve the project. And then the green signal was given, and I think Hilti was the solution which our guys have gone into total detail, understood it. Also the safety and precision was important here. It was to be seen like if these shots were, you know, misfired or something, it may end up somewhere else. So all those things were very well discussed, understood, taken approval and gone ahead.
It was like a bullet in a gun. Just they'll be doing that, so you'll see that sound also, bullet sound like. So we could able to see, and that should not go into any, it should not pierce into anybody, human being. That's very dangerous. So they have taken utmost care in erection part also.
See, this is one of the photograph. You can see this machine and the gun, and the guys holding it with the supported screw jacked sheet and fixing it.
That is touching with the
connected. I think once we finish, I think he can take some queries, answers, because we have whatever, we will try to show it, and then we can answer your fire protection things. Another thing, another challenge was moving the scaffolding. See, doing one floor is okay, but doing for multi-story is another challenge, and it was to be done repeated at every floor with scaffolding moving. So what we did, we made some false floor on, because now the challenge was, there is no deck sheet now below for doing the erection work at second floor. These are reinforcement bars which are only exposed, and there is no concrete also on top of it. So still you had to do the flooring from bottom. So we made some temporary floor arrangement and then moved. Like we have some photographs we will show you. Also another issue was the density of beam was not allowing us to lift any material within the building. It was to be lifted from outside only. And then trailing in inside was again becoming a major issue. So there also the erection team, our erection team had to work out some arrangement, take a load from the, you know, some pulley or chain pulley arrangement was made, which was safe as well as, you know, faster to shift the material and bring material inside the building. Otherwise, had this been a normal multi-story building, you could still use some area to lift the material, taking it up. Okay. So with these arrangements in place, eventually we could achieve still the 8-day cycle, which was the challenge in such a condition. And after all this thing, achieving 8-day cycle was the major achievement, which we'll say, to finish this building. I'll just show you one or two photographs. This is the unfinished portion of it before, you know, we can go further. The people are working, putting the deck sheet from bottom and fixing it with some supporting arrangements. This is the finished deck with capitals also, extra step there. There is another challenge, or you can say beauty of the building. The top super terrace was at 72 meter height with water tanks. Okay, and there also the detailing is the deck slab and then concreting and then waterproofing and achieving that. So the slab or the decking is used even for the water tanks here. I was telling you how this column was with the, you know, some reinforcement pushed before it is being poured with concrete. So this is how it was aligned inside and lifted, and also tag welded so as to that it remains in the position.
So one second, you can go back. So in that column also, we have taken some rips also. Once the concrete is poured, then it is likely to bulge also. So that's the reason we have given some members inside the column.
Stiffness. So building is complete. They are doing this facade work, and I think now they will be finishing it off also. So So you can see it is very similar to what the architect was looking at. We have done few projects like this. If I'll just go through, there are some 7-8 buildings right now which are under execution from various buildings, and some projects which we are doing, I'll take no further time. These are the projects which are under execution. I think that's it. Thank you.
So I'll just introduce my team. Mr. Balasubramanian is a steel structural design. Mr. Venu. Mr. Srihari and Mr. Mohan.
Mr. Sridhar was the detailed designer for this. Like once he has designed, he has to the connection designs and other thing was done by him. And Shashi was working for the total project management. We had the erection team also, but today they're not available. But the main contribution for execution was through them.